Ladies and gentlemen, friends of Israel, I stand here with a heart full of compassion. Compassion with the great state and people of Israel. A state founded on the principles of liberty and democracy. A state like an oasis in a region of violence and poverty. A state born out of an era with the harshest persecution mankind has ever seen. I stand here before you today with a heart full of joy. Joy because we are not standing alone. On the contrary, you are all here gathered today to say enough is enough. Israel, we stand with you. Israel, we have you back. And I stand here with a heart filled with determination. As a member of the Dutch parliament, I'm determined to speak out for the sake of Israel. And you see the sun is shining already. We have done so in the past, and we will do so in the future. We will not be silent. Today, the international community must face the fact the poison of anti-Semitism is as active and effective as ever. The virus remains widespread across our continent. Just a week ago, our national broadcast station reported the rise of anti-Semitism in the Netherlands. And what this means is best expressed by quoting one victim. We have to hide our Jewish identity. Think about it for a moment. Going into hiding. We have seen that before, and it's happening again today. Even though in Europe we said never again. Last week I spoke with a young lady from the Dutch city Almere. And she told me that her father had said her that's better to hide her necklace with the Star of David. The reason? Young immigrant children on the streets shouted that there had been a mistake in the past. Not her whole family had been murdered during the Second World War. It's terrible. It's heartbreaking. That's the situation of rising anti-Semitism. Friends of Israel, in an environment where Jews have to hide their identity and many still believe anti-Semitic conspiracy theories, in such a climate of distrust, hatred and insecurity, we should be more than careful when judging Israel. We should be balanced, thorough and truth-seeking. But in reality, the UN don't act on this way. On the contrary, Israel remains the main target of one-sided resolutions of UN bodies like the Human Rights Committee. It's nothing less than an obsession, in particular of Islamic countries in the Middle East. It's nothing less than an unacceptable encouragement of anti-Semitism. And this is what the UN Watch rightly points out, and let's applaud them for that. This is the reason why my party has in recent years proposed a parliamentary motion urging our government to combat the disproportional targeting of Israel within UN bodies. And thankfully, our motion was adopted. Now it's needed to put it into practice. And our goal is a full stop of the disproportional targeting of Israel. And if the Netherlands take this step, we won't be alone. Some states went before us, and more countries will hopefully follow until we end this injustice together. Until we end this injustice together. It's a shame that there is a permanent agenda item 7 about only Israel. It's a shame. And let me today make here in Geneva a concrete proposal for all the countries that are represented today. Ask your governments, ask your politicians, that as long as there is a specific item placed on the agenda of this Human Rights Council only about Israel, to vote against all resolution on this agenda item. Friends of Israel, in our present-day political and cultural climates, in which anti-Semitism and hatred against Israel are thriving, let's continue to show our love and compassion with Israel. Let's have joy about this massive show of support for Israel here today in Geneva. And let's stay determined to make a change for the better. And let's always keep praying for the peace of Jerusalem. Thank you.